Hello, YouTubers. I ain't said that in a while, and got another thing from BoxyCharm. So if you hear that racket, it is really windy outside, and I apologize. It seems like on my days off, it's like super windy. It kind of makes it difficult to do like a good ASMR. So I guess this can be kind of like a ASMR. Alright, so this is kind of a, it's a Final Times theme box. Yeah, mine's been, I don't have to for a couple days, so. Alright, so I got the Glow Essentials highlighter palette, and this is going for $40. That's all you need to get your, this palette is all you need to get your glow on. Each shade is buildable and easily glides on the skin and giving you a seamless glowing look. This box open. So I'll just throw it in all this way. Anyway, so. But I will keep the bubble wrap since I do a lot of shipping. This actually is really, really pretty. This is popping. Glowing. This is assy. Radiant pink. Gleaming. And beaming. Alright, that was really pretty. Just rub it off on my pants. Setting powder. Well, it looks like they did not give me a face cream, which I'm okay with. Because I've got a lot of face cream that I need to use up anyway. Hopefully, that one item, I'm not sure, it's not a face cream. Yeah, plastic. Thank you. If I can get into it, the plastic's on the stick. Classic's got a little static to it. It's gonna wanna stick. Hopefully this powder will be the right shape. Put it on. What shade it is. This is the I'm not sure how to pronounce it. It's OPV Beauty Loose Setting Powder, and it is going for $22. Perfect for setting your foundation or wearing on, whether you rely on setting powder to mattify, set, conceal, or diffuse. This formula acts as a finishing touch to bring your whole look together. That's something I hardly use, so I'll actually give this a shot. This one's really light. So I will give this a shot. Mine's a translucent powder, so okay, no wonder it's light. I mean, if I don't like it, I can just always give it away. Yeah, that's if I can get back one. And if I do like it, I can always give my Avon one away. Okay, this is a pineapple lip scrub. Where's the lip scrub? The rich and dulled sugar scrub is packed with juicy pineapple fragrance and exfoliating sugarcane crystals to gently buff and polish away dead skin cells. Plus an extra smoothing blend of the finest, I want to say barnacles, but it's probably not the word. Super hydrating coconut oil, a mix of cinnamon, orange, and vanilla essentials, oils to leave your lips soft and simple. Something. Ew, that juicy. Juicy. I got one sugar scrub from a Topic and it's rough. A little oil's got on my finger and it's definitely got some moles in it. So I think I might try this before I do all my makeup. Not done my makeup today. So this is a tone up primer. It's super black something. Look at that. Right. So let's see how much this is. This tone up primer is $35. This primer is the perfect first step to achieving a super food glow infused with eight powerful skin loving ingredients to help minimize the appearance of pores, fine lines, and wrinkles. Flat weight, satin formula creates an invisible skin, perfecting finish. So it's supposed to help increase longevity of foundation, moisturize and prep skin for makeup, satin tone of primer, blurs, imperfections, fine lines, and wrinkles, provides brighter and even skin tone, helps minimize the appearance of pores, powered by 8 super blocks essence, nourish skins, and with superfoods. So it's got black sesame oil, black tea, black rice, bunch of other stuff in it. And you can pause it and take a look if you like. So let's see what it looks like. So it's just a tube. Meaning an yin, Chinese color and face, English deep desire and passion. Vietnamese, calm and peaceful. Japanese, courtesy. So there's different meanings to yin, according to that. And the inside of the box is really pretty, but I don't think you can see it that well. So, got one more atom, which I don't know if I'll be crazy for or not. It's the 4-in-1 makeup brush. In an award-winning multitasker brush combination, the Nomasa combination with the Formosa Sensual and Sensual, if I can speak, makeup applicators. Including a sponge brush, brow, and eyeshadow brush, this compact game changer is all you need for a full face on the go or at home. Each is made of premium synthetic fibers. The brush is $28. So, voila. I think I've seen these on other people's channels, and I don't remember, like, much about it. This is a sponge. Got this. That's soft. I do like the color. Blue is one of my favorite colors. This twist. Got the brow. Which I typically don't do my brows. I'm not sure about that part. I mean, I'm sure this would be great if you do a lot of traveling. That's what I see this for. But I really don't see this like blending. Here and I'll see you in the bathroom to try the other scrubby out, because I also need to change my battery. I don't film in here much anymore. And I was kind of too lazy to set up the relax. I kind of need the sink in the way the bathroom is. It'd be kind of hard to do that. So this is the scrubby they sent me, which was, I forget how much it was. But the one I got from Hot Topic is a lot bigger, and I think this was $6. It was cherry, and this was just scrub. It's got no oil or nothing in it, and it feels a lot like the scrub Wayne has for the body. That's just a little rough. But I'm really excited to try this one. That one I got, it's cherry, and this one's the pineapple. So I'm just gonna get my finger a little wet. You can feel what's in it. It's gonna take a little because I don't want to use it all up since it's a little expensive. Tastes good. That's dangerous. I'm just gonna get a wet rag. I really want to lick my fingers. It tastes good. Well, I can't really tell yet, so I'll give it time to like really suck it up. But I can feel the oils on my finger, which is really nice. So I can tell it's gonna get my lip. Soft. So this is super exciting. Yeah, so I recommend that. I don't recommend this, but I've been trying to use it up because I don't want to like waste it. It's kind of a little too late to like give it away. Alright, I'll see you back in the bedroom. Alright, so we're back in the bedroom. So I'm going to go ahead and get started with this primer. Then I put some foundation on. Got silver thing on. So. Comes out like that. But it kind of looks like foundation. Bring in closer. It's got a slight smell to it, but it's not overpowering. I can't really smell it unless I like actually but it does have kind of a foundation smell. So if that makes sense. But it feels like it's going on like a cream. Thought I put too much, but during the wind, like it's supposed to snow a little bit tomorrow, but I'm not like worried about it. It feels like I put like face cream in. And that lip scrub I just got done with feels really good. I wish my lips stay dry in the winter anyway, so if it feels like it's starting to get a little rough, which I haven't put on chapstick since like last month. Should have kept that out. I'm gonna put on well, this one's supposed to be poreless anyway, so don't really tell a difference with this. Still see my pores, so I'm trying to use this foundation up since I've had it for a while, or the longest. It's Maybelline foundation. I kind of wish I did my eyeshadow first, but I could probably do a simple eyeshadow look. I don't know what, but I can do something simple. Alright, so I'm gonna grab a little bit more. Go up here with it. Am I off again? haven't got any foundation yet through BoxyCharm, so I'll try to use what I got from BoxyCharm. I'm kind of happy with this because normally foundation gets really bumpy, like right in there, and it's really not. Because I know if I use like stuff on my face, it's not that bad, but I just use whatever primer I can get my hands on. Alright, so since I'm doing ass first, I'll go ahead and add some eyeshadow primer. I got some, got one by e.l.f. and then I got one from Avon. I'm kind of feeling the e.l.f. one. Which I love the way this feels. I think this is the third time I've used this primer. And it does pretty good to be like really cheap. So you really don't have to spend a lot of money on something to get like a good product. Yeah, I think this is one of the shadows I got. All that, so I think I will do two different browns. I don't know why I didn't use this to put everything on. I guess I didn't want to get it dirty. Which, I'm going to get the stuff dirty anyway. I am going to use this, which is a skin tone. It's kind of like a base. I don't like how big it is in my hands when I try to apply it. Feels like I'm kind of pressing it down more. But the brush itself feels really good. God, I kind of hate how I can't get it out though. Thank you. I still love how the brush feels. So I think... I'm going to go with this imagine for the inner corner. It looks like it picks up a lot too. But it's not really going down. It's not that dark on the finger, but it just looks darker on the brush. There it goes. So I'm gonna go with this darker one for the outer corner. Okay, so I'm going to clean the fallout. Which I should have put powder down. I'm going to go clean that real quick and I'll go put some, try that translucent powder. Alright, so I'm going to need a good excuse to darn weird. Kinda irritating when I wanna record. Which I don't like the way the trailer sounds when it's windy anyway. I just don't like the wind. So I'm gonna try this sponge out. That just feels weird. I'm gonna put some in the cup. Tap, get in the cup. It has snowed on my shirt. That's not too bad. The band's not happy about it. Looks so weird. Was a little uneven. But I'm gonna get a blended blush. I mean, it's fine if you want to do like one color, but if you want to blend, you're going to have to have some skills, or I don't know, but I don't think I can blend with that blush. I mean, it's great for carrying like this brushes with you. I think it also keeps you busy keeping it clean too. Which is supposed to keep your brushes clean anyway. So I'm gonna use a little bit of white for the inner corner. That'd be a good idea to get all this powder off. I'm just gonna put a little bit of this encourage, like right here, give it some more color. Well, this video is gonna be long. That's okay. And I was going to use a little bit of that brown to go under my eye. Not all the way, just a little. And now I can use a little black in the inner corner. You can get it in my eyeball or on my tear duct thingy. Because it wants to be a peanut butter. I'm just being a silly, silly goose. So, I'm gonna use this brown eyeliner from A1. I got quite a bit left. Quite a bit. I've got two black ones almost. Used up, which is okay. This is the mascara I got. I think it's the first box I got. Also got something in my eye. Wouldn't be surprised. Chunky. I'm gonna use this CoverGirl and kind of like a fix that a little. I'm gonna get less clumpy. I'm gonna use kind of want to use a bronzer. I've been trying to use this one up and had it for a long time. Maybe to the pan, it's growing up so fast. Let's see the pan. My baby's growing up so fast. I'm such a weirdo. Yeah, this is a good brush, but I think this one's a little too big for bronzing for my taste. I guess I'm kind of used to that small bronzing brush. So I got the eyeliner to go. And I think this is the best part right here. If I can get it started. It's so satisfying. I want to do theming since I'm going for a brown theme anyway. That's really pretty. Don't know if you can see that up on my face or not, but I can build it up. So I'm gonna use a little bit of this powder. Should have used it before powder, but up before the hell up. I don't know if it'll damage it or not, so I'm just gonna go. So, this is the final look. Yeah. Alright, so I'm not sure where I'm going to put all this in my makeup case, but I will figure it out because I have this loose powder, which is a translucent powder too. I think I like the one I got today over this one. I still got this to use up, and it's a lot in here. But it's nice having an extra one. But there's nothing wrong with this one. So I'm kind of like, I want to keep it. Alright, this was fun. So, tell me what you think, and if you have a favorite makeup product, I would love to hear it. And if you got BoxyCharm in the past, I would love to hear your thoughts. I'll put a little bit of this one. Supposed to be hydrating. It's from Elf. Alright, I will see you lovelies in the next video.